Hello students, this is Professor Shrenik Shah. In this video, we are going to learn how to make a voltmeter from a galvanometer. Now we know galvanometer is an instrument which helps us to measure current in circuits. So let's say G is the resistance of the galvanometer and IG is the current passing through the galvanometer. So if we say the voltage which it can measure, it is going to be IG into G. By Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. Now we want to convert this into a voltmeter. Now voltmeter can measure potential difference across the devices, which even a galvanometer can do, because by current and galvanometer resistance we can multiply and find the potential difference across something. But the problem is the galvanometer can measure a very small potential difference. So basically, when I say I want to convert a galvanometer into a voltmeter, I want to increase the voltage measuring capacity of the galvanometer. Okay. First thing we need to know is voltmeter is always connected in parallel with the circuits, and therefore voltmeter must have very high resistance, or ideally infinite resistance. Now to make the resistance of the galvanometer high such that it can act like a voltmeter, we need to connect a high resistance in series, which means we will have a galvanometer and a very high resistance connected in series. Since the resistances are connected in series, the current passing through both of them will be same. So I can say IG remains as it is. Now definitely the voltage across this combination can be written as current passing through this into R plus G, which means V by IG is R plus G, and so R is V by IG minus G. So if we know what is the resistance of the galvanometer, what is the current measuring capacity of the galvanometer, and what is the maximum voltage capacity we want to make for the voltmeter, then using this formula we can calculate what resistance is to be connected with the galvanometer in series. Now apart from this, we have voltage ratio, which is denoted by N, and for the formula it is V by VG, which is nothing but the maximum voltage the voltmeter can measure upon the maximum voltage the galvanometer can measure or handle. Now if this ratio is N, we can use it over here in this formula to simplify it. Like R can be written as V upon IG, can be written as VG upon G. So VG upon G minus G. So IG is replaced as VG upon G. We can take G common, and V by VG can be written as N. So we will have N minus 1 into G as R. So this becomes another formula which we can use to find the value of resistance in series required to convert a galvanometer into voltmeter. I hope you understood this part. Thank you very much.